Okay, hi, welcome to the night flights. We go from Rotan to Katakamas on the mainland. I've added some weight in the back, so hopefully that'll fix that problem. And let's get this flight underway. As we go back to the mainland of Honduras. So we want PDF. Wind option 2, back. So we can do MHCA. Which you'll see is 96 nautical miles away. Let's put the fuel pumps on. And on. We'll be cruising today at 6,000 feet. Oil pressure is good. Always forget to do this bit. Feather. Cut off. Yeah, stabilizing nicely. Lights. And so yeah, go ahead, turn to the right. Out. And if I hold it back, it shouldn't do that with the weight in the back, hopefully. That still does it a little bit, but not as much, which is good. So we taxi on around now. Okay, brilliant. Stops that happening. Excellent. Let's get the heading. So prepare for our departure. Definitely helps when you put some weight in the back. The pilot's engage. Ease off that throttle a little bit. Some high was over there. The track. 157. So we head for the Honduran mainland. Now you can see it's not going to be on the chart by any stretch of imagination. Put the flaps fully up now. Katakamas is on the map, I don't believe that. There's the landing strip as well, just outside Katakamas. No way. HCA. Yeah, you're not going to find anything. Tell you what, you are. Nice. 6, runway 24, and HCA. So there's grass. Field elevation is 1,400 feet. Juris. Airport's a region now, that's something else. So they have a regional airport, but we're heading for something in a park, apparently. Obviously the weight's going to make us a bit slower, isn't it? I feel about that. Flight time is looking at 54 minutes. Airport. So we're seeing broken cloud 2,900 feet. That should be alright. Light winds. Coming on runway 6 then. So we continue our climb. So I don't know much about Honduras. The highest point. But there's some, looking at the map there, there's some pretty high ground to cover, so we have to be careful with that. Highest mountain. Which is 9,400 feet, so okay. So we're just passing 4,000 feet. So I'm glad putting weight in the back is changing the center of gravity. Further back has stopped that tail coming up so much. That's worked a treat, it has. Just need to remember to save the replay before turning the engine off, otherwise you lose it on this plane. A bit frustratingly. There we go. We are approaching the beautiful Honduran coast. It looks amazing. Might, for safety's sake, climb to 7,000. Yeah, take it up another 1,000 feet just to be on the safe side. So we climb above, because we know there's some high terrain there, right? Not too well. Battling a bit of a headwind for this leg. Wow. Here we go, folks. This is where it gets interesting. Did turn the lights off, didn't I? Yes, I did. Lamps are all up. Still got about 81 nautical miles to go, which is going to take me the best part of an hour. This leg of the tour. Let's have a look outside, see what's going on. There's where we departed. Here's where we're headed. Awesome. Thousand feet. There we go. Feet to our destination. Touch the dirt strip. In the middle of a freaking mountain range. I mean, why not? I mean, you could have given me the Katakamesis International Airport to land at. Main airport, but no. Let's give him some bush strip in the middle of the mountain range. Excellent idea. Which ideally I should have flown the island of this, because it has excellent terrain radar on it. Anyway, we will do it. Let's enjoy the beautiful Honduran coastline, because that is very nice. Wow, didn't realize it's as mountainous. I mean, I know South America, right, it's got mountains here. That's, well, we're still technically in Central America, I think, aren't we? Oh, yes. So, yeah, Central America rather than South America. Well, I suppose in some respects you'd call it South America, but I don't know, are you Honduran? Do you consider yourself Central American or Southern American? Because I suppose in terms of the continents, you have North America and South America, right? You don't have, you know, you don't have to hit Google. Okay, so world continents map. Here we go. Right. But according to this one, it's North America. Brilliant. Okay. Shows what I know. Yeah, but that makes sense in a way, I guess. Okay. If you're a Honduran, do you consider yourself North, Central, or Southern American? According to these continent maps, you're North American. Actually, if you're Honduran, you're probably not really thinking about it. I'm thinking, what a spectacular country you live in, all this coastline. Wow. Look at this. I'm liking it, for sure. So I don't know a lot about Honduras. Couldn't even tell you what the capital was. Although I'm going to now, with the aid of Google. Come on, think on it. Shouldn't I? Cuirass. Capital. Okay, capital is some totally unpronounceable word. That's nice. Take a Sigalpa, which I'm sure is pronounced nowhere near how I've just said it. Nice. We're not visiting there, unfortunately. I really need to do a lot more flying in South America, don't I? I know, I just said we're still in North America, actually. I'll just give up now. I need to do more flying in this part of the world. There we go. Get around it that way. Look. Okay, let's end it once before. I know the maps, literally everyone says it's North America. And I know you can kind of call it Central America, but deal with it. I'm going to call it South America. I suppose I should get it right. Anyway, good news, the weather looks pretty reasonable. Near a nice coastal mountain range here. The other good news is we've got a couple of legs flying in this country. Before we move on to drumroll, we've got quite a few legs actually. We've got Catacamas to Puerto Limpira. Puerto Limpira to Puerto Cabezas. Puerto Cabezas to Bluefields. And then we move on to what is that? Costa Rica, is it? Nicaragua, maybe? I don't know. I thought that's Costa Rica. Apparently we're going to... No, wait a minute. This is getting ridiculous now. Nicaragua. No, actually some of these legs may actually be in Nicaragua. Yes, Bluefields most definitely is in Nicaragua. So sorry, we haven't got all these. Why do they use the same flag? Oh, I see. On my list of destinations, right. They're not the same flag then, surely not. Honduras. Yeah, the Honduran one is lighter in colour. For a start. And it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stars, okay. Nicaragua. It's got something totally different, okay, because it just looks like... Oh no, my bad, I didn't... I have these really small... flags on my route thing, and from a distance they look the same, but when I look closer at the screen I can see they're different. And actually we have literally one more leg in this country, then we go into Nicaragua, then we go to Costa Rica, then we go to Panama, then we go to Colombia, and then we start working our way around the islands of Caribbean. Not doing very well with geography tonight, am I? So let's distract you with some beautiful views. And that, my friends, is a beautiful view. In fact, let's try and get there we go. Now we're talking. Down maybe. Yeah, that's good. That is just really nice actually. Spot for choice, which is a screenshot. Scenery, there's mountain ranges and valleys, and oh my word, is this awesome or is this awesome? Just look at those mountains, my word, is that epic or what? I feel the need at some point for a Honduras tour. quite epic, actually. I like it. Anyway, let's focus, because we have to remember we're landing at a tiny little grass strip in the middle of a foresty, mountainy area. Fortunately, we're in the right plane to do it. So this is kind of what I imagine the Congo would look like. Or should I say Democratic Republic of Congo, if we're across there. I imagine it'd be more like this, you know. But it obviously wasn't, for the most part. This cloud could make the landing a bit interesting. Especially as I don't have terrain radar on this plane. We shall see. We shall try and manage. Okay, let's be cautious here because there's cloud about and there's also a lot of high terrain about, which always makes me nervous. As I say, I don't think we've got any terrain radar options on. We have that, which is not very representative of anything. Display, no. GPS. Topography, oh, maybe that one. Tells me much really, does it? This is a Garmin what 1000. Good where we are here. There are some pretty high mountains. That's off key. That's it. There we go. Set the train, soft key. Topography, okay. It is. some impressive terrain, that's for sure. Just gotta be super careful about how we actually fly this. So we're heading direct for it at the moment, so we probably want to angle ourselves a little bit away if we're going to take runway 6. There's a lot of cloud about as well. So somewhere in this valley is a landing strip. So it's definitely a challenging flight, that's for sure. Let's see if any aircraft can get us down. This one sure as hell can. Is a problem. I feel a lot more comfortable in the Islander in weather like this. We like a challenge, it's half the fun, yeah? No fun unless it's a challenge, is it? This could be a bit of a problem trying to land, actually. So since I said we're going to have to pay close attention to terrain, so it's like another ridge there and then it drops down. But we've got to build up a cloud, which is exactly what we did not want. That's a high ridge. With if we don't seek to fly around it, come in from the other side, I think is what we're going to do. There we go. Clear that ridge, and then we should be all right, I reckon. Come down the other side of it into that valley. It's clearly there. And we should be alright. This is just epic flying across Honduras. I love it. Got south. North America. Why do I keep going this? This part of the Americas is really challenging to fly. That's great, isn't it? Absolutely fantastic. So, I think we have to fly a bit of a long approach in, get under this cloud, come up from Catacamas, fly in that way. It's 1,400 the elevation, we're currently at 7,000 feet, just as when I climb this high, but we're hitting some interesting weather, temperature 14 degrees up here. This cloud is not what I wanted. So I want to find some gap in the cloud that I can descend down through. But if anything, the cloud is getting progressively worse. Break. I'm just not going to get it, am I? Like images of Honduras. Yeah, how on earth are we going to find a grass strip in this conditions? So yeah, you'll see here, we want to come down across here, around up the valley, I reckon. It's our best chance. Otherwise we're just, yeah. You can see the mountains over there, right? That, I believe, is higher than me. So this future will change course, otherwise. Giving me some interesting problems. As it happens, the weather is closed in. I really need to get under this cloud base, which is why I want to wait till I'm over the green and I know I can safely drop down a couple of thousand feet and then hopefully get under the cloud base and have visual in to my destination. So this runway is 3,600 feet, but I don't quite believe that. Because the other thing said it's like 1,000 feet. Right, unless it made it longer. MHCA, ICAO. Civic. Small airport. Field elevation. Ah, field elevation, okay. So field elevation is that. What's the runway length then? Elevation. Right. So our range 17 miles. God, this weather is really closing in. Yeah, this. I know it's further south, but I remember the weather being like this a lot during some of my flights in Colombia. It's different because I used to do that in an A320, and obviously you could better guidance, but this is going to be interesting. I really need to get below this cloud sooner rather than later. In a minute we'll risk dropping down a little bit as we clear out to here. Oh, that's that clear patch coming up ahead here, hopefully. Hopefully. So you can see there's quite hot. Ugh, go look at those mountains off to the side there. Yeah. That's high ground. Just need to get down to that valley. Be able to see to get down into that valley as well would be ideal. My next KLM flight incidentally is to Quito, which has these sort of cloud problems. So I'm anticipating a tough time for that as well. Yeah, there's our valley. Okay, we can probably afford to start dropping shortly. This is a little look outside the plane, because these views are spectacular, right? Well, let's concentrate on what we're doing now. I believe we can start our drop down. Take down to 5,000 feet. Still about 60 nautical miles out. So perhaps descending a tad bit earlier than we need to. Let's hope we can get low enough to see where we're going. So there we go, we begin our descent. So come down into the valley. Here. between the two hills, right? This is where it has potential to go horribly, horribly wrong. What am I doing? Let's come in around the other side. This to be the better option. There we go. Awesome. Drop down to 5,000 feet. Somehow find this airfield. We're right in the cloud now, which is not helpful at all. But sure, there we go, that's better. So that's our valley. Still some 200 miles out, don't worry too much about that. It's a 6, right? Yeah. So coming in with the right approach idea, actually. Off another 1,000 feet, shall we? Try and get beneath this cloud base would be ideal, really. There we go, brilliant. We're beneath the cloud base, we're down into the valley. Excellent. Let's focus on the job in hand. Okay, get to get this. So we have to think to look at Google Maps. Thank you. on me. Where the hell are we going? Let's get a fucking thing recording so we don't have to worry about that. It's got it, it's there. Definitely there. Well, it's not going to be up in those mountains, is it? That's ridiculous. It's got to be here, right? Let's come down to 3,000 feet. No way it's going to be up in those mountains, that's just ridiculous. Because they rise high up, so it's got to be down here somewhere, right? I just don't know why the fucking thing's there, it's ridiculous. Where does it place? See, we'll be careful because there's another airfield. MH. C. MHG, MHGE, where the hell is that? MHG doesn't exist. So there's no way it's up in those mountains, or it has to be down here. There's a freaking river here somewhere. It's got to be that strip there by the road, surely. Oh hello, what's this down here? That's not a runway. Can't see anything. Desperately trying to find anything that resembles a freaking runway. Is that it? No, it just looks like a road. Okay, I have something dead ahead. Stay game now. something there. This is the other side of the river, which I'm bearing down on dead ahead. I should make for that. Crap. Put a pilot off. Bring my nose down. I just can't see diddly shit. The sun's bloody shining off it. Is that it there? Yes. That's the other runway, don't I? Ah, Jesus, crapping. That's the only airfield I can see. There's literally nothing here. Well, tell you what, let's land there and see what my hello. They want to get back in the cockpit now, thank you. Let's land here and see what we get, because we're landing at MG. There's just no airfield there though. Jeez, we're landing at the wrong airstrip, but we'll do it. We'll see if Skytrack lets us get away with it. I certainly didn't see an airfield, did you? Now this just bothers me. Land here. I didn't see a single thing resembling an airfield. And why would you have one literally just like a mile or two short of the other one? Doesn't make any freaking sense, right? Only thing is, it said it's a grass strip. That's what bothers me. But we'll put it down here and see if Skytrain lets me get away with it. Pretty sure this is not the airfield, but I mean, if you go by my Navigraph thing, it should be up in the mountain somewhere, but that's just ridiculous. This isn't it. Crap. Okay. I don't know where the airfield is then. I suspect if we start it up again. Save the replay, idiot. Anyway, can't believe I've done that again. Let's finish that. I want to go and find out where this airfield actually is.